Yeah, this is the Hanford High School Symphony Orchestra, which we haven't had for the last few years, which because we've all been busy with stuff. But this is one of the coolest things that I get to do as a teacher here at Hanford, is work with all of these students, but especially when we get to put a total collaboration together, where we collaborate with the... somebody dropping chains back there. where we get to collaborate with our band program under the direction of Mr. Adam Hancock, and with our percussionists and all of our string groups. So this is string orchestra. String orchestra, raise your hand. Yeah. Right. Symphonic orchestra, raise your hand. Symphonic orchestra. Cool. Symphonic orchestra won second at the state orchestra festival. They beat our top. And chamber orchestra. And before I forget this, this is the most important thing I'll do all night, is I want to take a second and thank all of our seniors. Band, percussion, strings included. I could go on and on about each and every one of these students. But they had the weirdest high school experience ever. And the fact that they stuck with it and are here today and are performing, I really wanted this concert to be kind of a celebration of sticking with it. And so anyway, seniors, can you all stand up, please? Super, super amazing kids, and I was telling somebody backstage, they were like, oh man, so I was like, have a great last concert, and they're like, oh man, I'm sad. I'm like, no, it's just the beginning. It's just the beginning of the next chapter, and hopefully when you leave Hanford, you go on and you experience the next thing, and the foundation that you have here as a musician and as a person sets you up to be successful for the rest of whatever you choose to do. So that's our goal here, and hopefully we have... you know, we make memories that are that last a lifetime. So anyway, seniors, thank you. Appreciate you. Appreciate you all, but seniors, you know. I have been super blessed this semester, this quarter, to have an incredible student teacher from Central Washington University. And he's done a lot of work with our jazz ensemble. He's done a lot of work with our orchestras and our band. When you student teach with me, a lot of times their band kids come and student teach with me, and my day is kind of a little weird because I teach jazz ensembles and I teach orchestra, which is a weird combination, but it's perfect for me. I love it. So Logan has done a great job of kind of learning some new skills. He's a bass trombone player and teaching strings for the first time and doing all that. So he's gonna wow you with his awesome musicianship leadership here for the next two songs, but I'll let him introduce these pieces. But I want to give a special thank you and shout out to an amazing student teacher who we wish all the best to, Logan Borchardt.
Pleasure, everyone. It's been just an absolute pleasure to work with all these students. I think this is five different classes on stage right here. It's crazy. But it's been great. They're just amazing. And I'd like to thank my mentors, Chris Newberry and Adam Hancock, for all their support and just helping me grow as a musician and as an educator. You just heard the arrangement of symphonic dances from Fiddler on the Roof. And next year, you heard the Intermezzo Sinfonico from the Capriola Rusticana. Thank you. Back to the stage.
One more time for Logan Borchardt. Logan mentioned that this is five different classes. Five different classes. And you might be wondering, like, oh, how does that work? Maybe not, but I'm going to tell you anyway. We rehearse all five classes separately. So, you know, as classes come, we work all this music that you're hearing tonight in small groups. It just so happens that our symphonic orchestra and wind ensemble meet at the same hour. So we've, over the last month and a half, 2 months, we've had the wind ensemble kids in to rehearse with us 1 day a week. And then percussion meets at the same time as chamber orchestra. So they've been coming in 1 day a week. And then yesterday we had our first rehearsal with all of us together in one room, which is cool. And the amount of improvement from the beginning of that rehearsal to the end of that rehearsal was amazing. And then we had another short rehearsal today after school. So we've put this all together kind of in pieces. I told them it's like building an airplane. Like you build the wings in like Texas, you build the fuselage in Pennsylvania, and then all ships to like Everett, so we put it all together. And so this is like Everett. But that's what we've done. So we've had two rehearsals together, and it's so much fun. I'm jealous of Logan getting to conduct that last piece. But I'll just do it again sometime. Speaking of doing it again, some of you have maybe heard rumblings of some plans for next year, but we're pretty close to finalizing an opportunity for this group or a version of this group to perform next year at Carnegie Hall in New York. As you can imagine, there's lots of planning and details that are going into that, and I was hoping tonight to have like an itinerary and some information about that, but we're making some adjustments to it. So just know, parents, that some of you guys are going like ding ding ding, price tag. I totally get it. The trip is going to happen in mid-April. So just be maybe mentally starting to gear up for that, and in the next week or two before school gets out, I'm going to be trying to send home all the information you're going to need regarding that event and that opportunity. It's going to be pretty amazing. So looking forward to that. And it was actually the kids' fault, I'm going to tell you this. The kids were like, Mr. Newberry, when you were a freshman, you went to Orlando with the orchestra and they got to perform, and we've been waiting for our trip this whole time. And now we're going to be seniors next year and we don't get to do anything. So anyway. There's some people over here whose fault it is. So anyway, we're really excited about it. We're going to have lots of fundraising opportunities to help with that. And you'll be hearing a lot more about that if you're a parent or a student going on that trip. So I apologize. I was hoping to have all my ducks in a row, but I don't yet. Still waiting on some details. Cool. I want to thank our admin, Mr. Christensen, Mr. Gaddis, Mr. Shaver, Ms. Spencer, for their support in our music program. It's been a trying couple of years, and I think we're coming out of it, and it's really exciting. I'm really thrilled to be here. I'm really thrilled to be making music, to be looking at an audience again. It's amazing, and I don't take that for granted. So I want to thank them for their support, the Richland School District, all that stuff. Parents, you are the best. And thank you for supporting your students in music, and it will pay off, I promise. Manny, everybody wave at Manny in the back. Manny today, I don't know if you realize it, but Manny reminded me today, with everything happening in our world, he reminded me today that Manny lived in Ukraine for 6 years? You said 6 years, right? Yeah, and Manny reminded me today how powerful music is, because with all the crazy stuff that's happening, and even just in the past few days, life is hard, and it's challenging, and it's confusing, but music is beautiful. So, music is beautiful, and sharing music together is beautiful, and it brings people together, and it brings hope in darkness. And I hope you enjoyed my song. Thank you.
Noah loves you too. Thank you so much for coming. Our jazz night, our last concert of the year, is Tuesday at 6 p.m.